The Warriors remained unbeaten after beating the Timberwolves last night. Steph Curry on fire. He's leading the league in scoring at nearly 32 points per game. KG is thoroughly impressed. Garnett spoke to Jerry Zagoda from the Minneapolis Star Tribune last night after the loss. And Zagoda tweeted this from their convo. KG saying, like Michael Jordan was a whole other thing. This guy is his own thing. It's beautiful for basketball. Stephen A., you okay with KG putting Curry and MJ in the same sentence?
Skip Bayless, Molly, Gurum, let me say this. Yes, I am.
Ooh, really?
Yes, I am. Mm. And KG, who I believe, even though I think he'll end up as a part owner of the Minnesota Timberwolves, if he wanted a career in this business, he could have it because he's the real deal. He doesn't mince words. He's going to say what he feels, and he's usually right on the money, and he is as real as they come. Mm-hmm. He doesn't say this lightly, and it's not meant as any kind of disrespect whatsoever to the great Michael Jordan. But Steph Curry, I'm going to say it right here on the airwaves right now. Steph Curry is the best player in the world. I'm going to say that. I know that LeBron can do more on the defensive end.
Yep.
I know that Kevin Durant is a freak of nature. But LeBron can't do what Steph Curry can do offensively. And Kevin Durant doesn't want to do bad enough what Steph Curry does offensively. Because Steph Curry goes out there, and despite having Klay Thompson, a member of the Splash Brothers, and the Harrison Barnes, and Andre Iguodala, and all of these guys around him who are capable scorers, Steph Curry gonna shoot that basketball. And you know how you know what the ultimate testament to his greatness is? He can shoot as much as he wants, and nobody has a thing to say. Why? Because it's usually going in. 53% shooting from the field. Yep. 47% shooting. I'm going to repeat that number, Skip. 47% shooting from three-point range. This brother is on another level. And when listen, he can't jump like Michael Jordan. He's not the aerial assault that Michael Jordan was, okay? He certainly can't do defensively what Michael Jordan did and what LeBron James is capable of doing. But from an offensive standpoint, first of all, Golden State's seventh defensively, by the way. And Steph Curry can't play a little defense. It ain't like he's a scrub on the defensive end of the floor. But offensively, how are you going to stop him? This dude literally walks past half court, and you are shivering and shaking in your proverbial boots because this brother can pull up from 40 the way some people can pull up from 10 feet away from the basket. He is that lethal of a marksman. I'm going to say it again. He is the greatest shooter I have ever seen in my life. I have never seen anybody. I'm talking about Larry Bird. I'm talking about somebody most of y'all don't know. Andrew Toney. You can appreciate that name, Skip. I'm talking about Ricky Paris. I'm talking about Del Curry. I'm talking about downtown Freddie Brown from the 70s with Dennis Johnson and Jack Sigma and those boys in Seattle with the Supersonics. I don't care who you pick. I have never in my life seen a basketball player who can shoot the basketball the way that Steph Curry can. And because of that level of paranoia that he instills in a defender, that's what makes him comparable to Michael Jordan. It's not just the efficiency, it's the fear he instills. It's the way he demoralizes you. Because what are you going to do? You can't block a shot from 30 or 40 feet. This is how lethal this kid is. And that is why I think the comparison to Michael Jordan in terms of impact is exactly what KG was alluding to. I think he is right on the money because he scares the living hell out of the defenders. His marksmanship, he is changing the game. It is beautiful for basketball because guess what? You don't have to be 6'6 and above flying through the air in order to be proficient. You can be 6'3 with a J and make noise in the National Basketball Association. He is changing the complexion of how basketball should be. It is something special to behold.
It is that. I hear everything you just said, and I don't love what KG did. I'm sorry. Just don't go there yet. It's just, this is unfair to Steph. I'm sorry to put him in the same sentence, even though what Kevin was saying was what Michael did in this area is is very special. And now what he's doing, Steph, over here in this area is very special. He wasn't saying Steph's better than Michael. Mm-hmm. He's just saying both things very special to watch. Mm-hmm. I get that. But too many people will now connect the dots to say, wait a second, is Steph better than Michael Jordan? Mm-hmm. Look, I'm the biggest Jordan fan on the planet. I said, though, before Steph's draft, I'm going to remind you again, I said, take him number one over Blake Griffin. And people laughed at me. Are you kidding? That skinny little kid from David? You'd take him over Blake Griffin? Yes, I would, because of the handle and the range. It's just, I've never seen it before. Mm-hmm. You know what he reminds me of? When I was a little kid, I would go see the Harlem Globetrotters every year. That's when I'm a little kid. That's a long time ago. Mm-hmm. But Meadowlark Lemon was doing things that were magic on the court. Like no human can do that magic trick on the court, like shoot a hook shot from half court as if it's a free throw and make it. And Steph is shooting threes as if they're layups. Yeah. Like you say, he's making almost half of them. Well, he's making 5.2 a game. The record he set last year for per game threes, 3.6. Now, again, we're only 10 games into the season. But it's we've never seen this before. I thought Pete Maravich, this is a little before your time, but in college there's no three-point line, but he was shooting these kind of shots, but not like this. Like I thought that was something. Now, this is another level of that. But remember, just for the record now, just for perspective, Michael Jordan could destroy you on both ends of the floor, offensively, defensively. Mm-hmm. He could shoot it okay, pretty well outside, well enough outside, and he could attack the basket like no one's ever attacked the basket and get to the free throw line and make all the clutch shots, and then he could go to the other end and just terrorize you. He could take you out of what you do on the defensive end. I'm sorry, I can't connect those dots just yet.
Let me say something to you that I've never said to you on this show. It might be in all probability an exercise in futility, but I think that I can possibly change your mind. Let me take a shot at it.
Try.
When you look at Steph Curry, we understand what you're saying about the defensive end of the floor. What KG is talking about is somebody that literally changes the complexion of a game, the level of fear that he instills in you. If you remember Michael Jordan before the championships, when he couldn't get through the Pistons, mm-hmm. it got to a point where you saw this kid coming and you're like, good Lord have mercy. His second year in the league, when he dropped 63 on Boston and Larry Bird called him the closest thing to God he had ever seen. Mm-hmm. The Pistons said, damn all that. Bad Boy Pistons, Dumars and Isaiah and Lambert and Rodman and Mahorn and all of these boys. They said, we going to put something on you, Chuck Dilly, the Jordan rules.
That's what it was.
I am telling you right now, the reason why this is relevant to Steph Curry is because I ain't wishing, he's my favorite player. And we live in a different age and we are not advocating violence for ignorant individuals out there who will try to interpret it as such. At some point in time, somebody going to try to put in some Steph rules. Just like they had to put in a Jordan rule. Because this makes no sense. He comes past half court and pulls up anywhere and has the total green light. And by the way, his teammates get mad at him when he doesn't shoot because that's how lethal he is.
True.
Who else other than Jordan has ever had that kind of green light? Not even Kobe had that kind of green light. He might have taken it, but he didn't have it. Because even when he did it, there were people that would get annoyed with it or whatever. Nobody's got a problem with Steph, just like they didn't have a problem with Michael Jordan. Because this dude, Skip, let me read these numbers to you. 33.3 points, very Jordan-esque. 53% shooting from the field, very Jordan-esque.
Sure.
Not from the three-point range, 47%. That wasn't Jordan-esque.
No.
92% from the free throw line. The man doesn't miss from anywhere. He shoots in his sleep. He shoots awake. He shoots on the left side, the right side, the corner, the wing, the key, the top of the key, back pass, half court. It doesn't matter. Any place he throws the ball up, it goes in. Nobody has had that kind of impact offensively. And you can appreciate this point, Skip. When you have that kind of impact offensively,
mm-hmm.
it demoralizes guys when they're on offense because they might overcompensate. It's similar to what's happening with the Patriots. They're so precise and such perfectionist at what they do that normalcy doesn't apply when you're going against the Patriots. Mm-hmm. You see folks engaging in trickery and trying extra things because they're going against Tom Brady mm-hmm. and okay. Bill Belichick.
All right.
That's what you're going to see people
All
doing.
Right. I got
Steph
it.
Curry.
Okay. Two quick questions. Hypothetical.
Okay.
if there were an all-time draft in which you could draft that player and in his young prime, okay, to start your franchise with, where would Steph go in that all-time draft? You could draft anybody.
I say for who? Compared to?
Anyone.
All-time.
Well, listen.
You can start it. Who would go number one? Michael Jordan.
Thank you. Michael Jordan for me. But what I'm saying to you is this. It's not eclipsing. Nobody said that. What you're talking about with Michael Jordan, let's understand that for us, Bill Russell, the ultimate champion with 11 championships in 13 years. Michael Jordan, the greatest most of us have ever seen. So when you're talking about somebody, what you're asking is not who's better. Who deserves to be mentioned in the same sentence, the same breath in terms of impact? What you're seeing from Steph Curry right now is comparable to what they said about Michael Jordan
at the time
he was going. Okay. And that's what I'm saying.
Magic in his young prime or Steph in his young prime. I'd go Magic.
Let me tell you why.
Intangibles.
I understand
six,
that.
6'9".
I understand that. But what I'm saying to you is this. Magic in terms of impact and the troops around him being made to look better. I'm not looking at that. I understand Magic gets that edge. I'm talking about in terms of ability.
Okay.
I got it.
Quick question. Hypothetical draft going into this season, if any GM could draft a player to start with just this year, just as
based on what we're seeing
on the current players, who would go number one in that draft going into this year?
I think they would say LeBron.
They would say LeBron.
I am telling you right now,
okay,
what I'm seeing offensively from this kid, Skip, when you shoot this accurately and you create your own shot. You need some spot-up shooter like a Steve Kerr, John Paxson or somebody. Oh. You boogieing off on the old dribble. And you know how much I love Chris Paul. You know how much I love Russell Westbrook as players.
Sure.
This brother's on another level. Mm-hmm. I mean, right now, Steph Curry, I'm going to say it because I think Kevin Durant is one of the top three players on the planet. And obviously LeBron is. I'm going to say right now with what we're seeing these first 10 games, that right now Steph Curry is the best player on earth,
and we might not have even seen the best.
And I'm saying it because you got to score. You can defense wins championships, you got to score points to win games.
Yeah,
and this brother right here is on another level. It's on another level.
Yes,
I mean,
no.
There's no way to deny it.
Yes or no, have we seen the best of him, or you think there's another game?
I can't. If it should be unlawful for him to be better than he looks.
Yeah, okay,
like.
All right,
I mean, if he's better than this,
all right.
What's it say?
He leads the league in threes and is second in the league with layups as well. Just so impressive. Ridiculous season. Oscar De La Hoya writes a letter to Floyd in Playboy magazine. It starts, "Dear Floyd." It's classic. But do the guys think it's valid? We'll tell you all about it when we come back.
Well, he's making 5.2 a game. The record he set last year for per game threes, 3.6. Now, again, we're only 10 games into the season, but it is... we've never seen this before. I thought Pete Maravich, this is a little before your time, but in college there's no three-point line, but he was shooting these kind of shots, but not like this. Like I thought that was something. Now, this is another level of that. But remember, just for the record now, just for perspective, Michael Jordan could destroy you on both ends of the floor, offensively, defensively. He could shoot it okay, pretty well outside, well enough outside, and he could attack the basket like no one's ever attacked the basket and get to the free throw line
right.
And make all the clutch shots, and then he could go to the other end and just terrorize you. He could take you out of what you do on the defensive end. I'm sorry, I can't connect those dots just yet.
Let me say something to you that I've never said to you on this show. It might be in all probability and exercise and futility. But I think that I can possibly change your mind. Let me take a shot at it.
Try.
When you look at Steph Curry, we understand what you're saying about the defensive end of the floor. What KG is talking about is somebody that literally changes the complexion of a game, the level of fear that he instills in you. If you remember, Michael Jordan, before the championships, when he couldn't get through, I know that LeBron can do more on the defensive end.
Yep.
I know that Kevin Durant is a freak of nature. But LeBron can't do what Steph Curry can do offensively. And Kevin Durant doesn't want to do bad enough what Steph Curry does offensively. Because Steph Curry goes out there, and despite having Klay Thompson, a member of the Splash Brothers, and the Harrison Barnes, and Andre Iguodala, and all of these guys around him who are capable scorers, Steph Curry gonna shoot that basketball. And you know how you know what the ultimate testament to his greatness is? He can shoot as much as he wants, and nobody has a thing to say. Why? Because it's usually going in. 53% shooting from the field. 47% shooting. I'm gonna repeat that number, Skip. 47% shooting from three-point range. This brother is on another level. And when listen, he can't jump like Michael Jordan. He's not the aerial assault that Michael Jordan was, okay? He certainly can't do defensively what Michael Jordan did and what LeBron James is capable of doing. But from an offensive standpoint, first of all, Golden State's seventh defensively, by the way, and Steph Curry can't play a little defense. It ain't like he's a scrub on the defensive end of the floor. But offensively, how are you going to stop him? This dude literally walks past half court, and you are his teammates get mad at him when he doesn't shoot because that's how lethal he is.
True.
Who else other than Jordan has ever had that kind of green light? Not even Kobe had that kind of green light. He might have taken it, but he didn't have it because even when he did it, there were people that would get annoyed with it or whatever. Nobody's got a problem with Steph, just like they didn't have a problem with Michael Jordan. Because this dude, Skip, let me read these numbers to you. 33.3 points, very Jordan-esque. 53% shooting from the field, very Jordan-esque.
Sure.
Not from the three-point range, 47%. That wasn't Jordan-esque.
No.
92% from the free throw line. The man doesn't miss from anywhere. He shoots in his sleep. He shoots awake. He shoots on the left side, the right side, the corner, the wing, the key, the top of the key, back pass, half court. It doesn't matter. Any place he throws the ball up, it goes in. Nobody has had that kind of impact offensively. And you can appreciate this point, Skip. When you have that kind of impact offensively, it demoralizes guys when they're on offense because they might overcompensate. It's similar to what's happening with the Patriots. They're so precise and such perfectionist at what they do that normalcy doesn't apply when you're going against the Patriots. Mm-hmm. You see folks engaging in trickery and trying extra things because they're going against Tom Brady and Bill Belichick.
All right.
That's what you're going to see. This dude literally walks past half court and you are shivering and shaking in your proverbial boots because this brother can pull up from 40 the way some people can pull up from 10 feet away from the basket. He is that lethal of a marksman. I'm going to say it again. He is the greatest shooter I have ever seen in my life. I have never seen anybody. I'm talking about Larry Bird. I'm talking about somebody most of y'all don't know. Andrew Toney. You can appreciate that name, Skip. I'm talking about Ricky Paris. I'm talking about Del Curry. I'm talking about downtown Freddie Brown from the 70s with Dennis Johnson and Jack Sickman, those boys in Seattle with the Supersonics. I don't care who you pick. I have never in my life seen a basketball player who can shoot the basketball the way that Steph Curry can. And because of that level of paranoia that he instills in a defender, that's what makes him comparable to Michael Jordan. It's not just the efficiency, it's the fear he instills. It's the way he demoralizes you. Because what are you going to do? You can't block a shot from 30 or 40 feet. This is how lethal this kid is. And that is why I think the comparison to Michael Jordan in terms of impact is exactly what KG was alluding to. I think he is right on the money because he's